نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، ما يهدي الله فلا مضل له وما يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, all praise due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His help and His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from our soul's evils and our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can guide. I bear witness and testify that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And I bear witness and testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, the miracle given to Moses and Jesus was for that time. Their miracle is not with us, but the miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Quran. So you see it from now until the day of judgment. In the Quran, Allah challenges the pagan Arabs to produce a book like the Quran, and they couldn't. Then He tells them to produce 10 chapters like the Quran, and they still couldn't. Then Allah makes the challenge easier by telling them to produce a book like the Quran, a chapter like the Quran, and they still couldn't do it. Then Allah says, bring speech similar to it, and if you cannot do it, then they will never be able to do it, then therefore fear Allah Azza wa Jal. The Quraysh, my dear brothers, used to pride themselves with the Arabic language. To prove that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a true prophet, Allah Azza wa Jal gave him the Quran with its beauty and eloquence. A very well-known incident, the incident of Walid al-Mughira. And he was one of the most famous poets during his time. He is the father of who? Khalid ibn Walid. He is the father of Khalid ibn Walid. Walid al-Mughira. He was one of the most famous poets during his time. And once he passed by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting some Quran. And this affected Walid al-Mughira. He went back to his people shaking and trembling, as this affected Walid al-Mughira. And the people heard that this affected him, and Abu Jahl told Walid that our community had heard, you better say something about this man, meaning Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he, Walid, said, what do you want me to say? For I swear by Allah, there is none amongst you who knows poetry more than I do. No one can compete with me in poetry, not even the jinns. I swear by Allah, what I heard does not bear any similarities that I know. The speech which he says is so sweet, and it is adorned with beauty and charm. Its first part is fruitful, and last part is abundant, meaning full of meanings. And it shatters, and it remains unconquered, and it shatters anything which came before or after it. So he, Abu Jahl, he said, you must speak against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or you will get into trouble. So he, Walid, thought and planned. And Allah mentions this in the Quran, how Walid thought and planned. And he said, this is some type of magic. And Allah mentions this in the Quran. Another incident, my dear brothers, the incident of Utbah ibn Rabi'. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He wanted to convince him to leave Islam, to leave this message, to leave the Quran. And then when he approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he approached him. And then after that, he told him, have you finished? He said, yes. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started reciting Quran. And this mesmerized Utbah ibn Rabi'. He was mesmerized. And when he went back to his people, they noticed he is not the same person that left them. And he, Utbah, said, I have heard speech which I have never heard before. I swear it's not magic nor sorcery. O Quraysh, leave this man alone. For I swear by Allah, this speech will be a cause of a great event amongst the Arabs. And subhanAllah, this speech, which is the Quran, was a big cause amongst the Arabs. So in today's brief khutbah, my dear brothers, I want to summarize and talk about, mention seven examples of why and how the Quran is miraculous. Number one, of the primary ways that the Quran is miraculous, and that is the most obvious way, and that is the most clearest of ways of the Arabs of old, is the language, the style and the syntax, the rhetoric and the eloquence and the rhythm of the Quran. No other book can compete with the beauty and the power of the Quran. The words that Allah chooses, the context, the precise synonym, the unique sentence, the syntax, the structure, which is unique in human history. Any book, my dear brothers, you can kind of detect who the author is because the mind is one. And that is why till this day, when you come across a book whose author is unknown, you have specialists, they go through the book. Did Shakespeare write this book? Was this written by Plato, for example? Because there's a style. The Quran has no such style that you can categorize. And every one of us who reads the Quran, he knows this firsthand. The Quran does not have any standard style. It is absolutely unique in its own style. When Allah mentions punishments and Jahannam, the words become difficult to pronounce. Dad and Ghain and Ain. When Allah mentions Jannah, easier words to pronounce. Salsabil, Sin and Lam and Ba. Even in the consonants, my dear brothers that are chosen, we see the beauty and the power of the Quran. So the number one method to prove that the Quran is miraculous is the language of the Quran, is the language of the Quran. Number two, of the ways the Quran is miraculous as well. And this is something we don't concentrate on. This is something which is oft neglected, is the stories of the Quran. Is the stories of the Quran. The Quran mentions stories and the prophets of old. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had no access to these stories. He did not know how to read and write. Even if he knew how to read and write, there was no Bibles translated in the Arabic language during his time. He did not know anything about Jesus and Moses. He had no access to these stories. The Arabs during his time couldn't care less about Bani Israel. And you've got stories that talks about the prophets and talks about the children of Israel. From where did all this Quranic knowledge come from? Allah mentions in the Quran, وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ. You did not know, O Messenger of Allah. This is the knowledge of the unseen. We are the ones who tell you these stories. You weren't there when Moses was on Mount Sinai. You weren't there when people were distributing with the care of Maryam. You weren't there when with regards to the brothers of Yusuf and how they disputed amongst themselves. So where did this knowledge come from? This all came from Allah. And this proves its authenticity. Because a man that had no knowledge of these stories, where did these stories all come from? Obviously, it is from the divine. Obviously, it is from Allah Azza wa Jal. And as I said, he was an unlettered prophet. He did not know how to read and write. And even if he knew how to read and write, there was no Bibles translated in the Arabic language during his time. So number two are the stories of the Quran. Number three of the miracles of the Quran, my dear brothers, is the content, the law, the theology, the social structure, the ethics, the morality. For a book to come with this framework of laws that was unprecedented in human civilization, to preach things that was unheard of. It was unheard of, my dear brothers, to preach human equality. It was unprecedented in any civilization to preach that all men are equal before Allah. All the children of Adam are equal before Allah. There is no superiority of one race over another. This was unheard of, my dear brothers, especially during that time. And yet the Quran comes and he explicitly preaches, "Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum." We have made you nations and tribes, so you can get to know one another, not so you can hate one another. And the best amongst you are those who have taqwa. The best amongst you are the most righteous. So the content of the Quran is yet another manifestation of its authorship. Number four of the miracles of the Quran. And this is something that we can feel and taste, is the impact it has on its listeners. What happens when we listen to the Quran? The movement of our hearts, the alignment of the qalb with the recitation of the Quran. No one can remain unmoved when they listen to the Quran. And Allah mentions of the people of the book. Allah talks about the people of the book. When they listen to the Quran, تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيدُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ. You find their eyes begin to cry when they listen to the Quran. This is the effect it has on its listeners. Even if you don't understand Arabic, it has that effect, my dear brothers. How many people have become Muslims because of the Quran? You just go on YouTube, you see. Many people have accepted Islam because of the Quran, and they did not understand Arabic, but it is the effect that it has on the heart. And this is a living miracle, my dear brothers. And wallahi, you know when you listen to the Quran, you know this is from Allah. Wallahi, when you listen to it, you know this is from Allah. My dear brothers, whenever you feel depressed, whenever you feel lonely, whenever you feel that you've got there's no other avenue, no, then my dear brothers, recite the Quran. Open the book of Allah. Get a qari that you love to, you love his voice, and listen to it with an open heart. And Allah Azza wa Jal will remove that depression, that loneliness that you're feeling, my dear brothers. And this is a living miracle. Number five of the miracles of the Quran as well. And this is the most important, that the Quran has been preserved like no other book. And it is truly phenomenal, my dear brothers. When you study other scriptures, the Old and New Testament, their gaiters, there is no comparison whatsoever. We have mushafs, carbon 14 dated, back to the era of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Just recently, they discovered a copy of the Quran currently housed in the University of Birmingham in England. And it is now scientifically proven that those parchments of the Quran were written within 10 years, plus or minus, in the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some even say it was written during his lifetime. And if you compare that to the modern copy of the Quran, it is word for word. We have inscriptions, we have calligraphy, we have coins dating back to the Sahaba and the Tabi'un. And the greatest aspect of the Quran, my dear brothers, it is mutawatir in recitation. Millions upon millions of people are reciting the same thing. So it is not just a written book, it is the oral preservation. It is the oral preservation, and that's what makes it a miracle. Number six, my dear brothers, of the miracles, one of the miracles of the Quran is how many huffaz do we have? How many people have memorized the Quran cover by cover? No book has been memorized like the Quran, and that is a miracle in itself. And my last point, my dear brothers, number seven, is that I will mention there are many scientific miracles that we find in the Quran that does not contradict with modern discoveries, my dear brothers. For example, the Earth's atmosphere, on human embryonic development, on mountains, on the origin of the universe, seas and rivers, on clouds, and miracle of iron, and so on and so forth. And there are many, many other more, my dear brothers. As Allah says in the Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. That do they not consider the Quran carefully? Had it been from other than Allah, you will find many contradictions in it. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. My dear brothers, just a reminder that tomorrow inshallah is the day of Arafat, so try to fast on that day. And if you do fast inshallah, that's 2 years of your minor sins will be wiped away inshallah. So try to fast tomorrow. Also, Qurban, my dear brothers, our brothers, MATW project, if you haven't done your qurban, this is your opportunity. Just speak to the brothers here, inshallah. So try to do it before Eid. And also, announcement for the Eid prayers will be 8 o'clock, inshallah, at the Aquatic Center in Hurstville. 8 a.m. inshallah at the Aquatic Center in Hurstville this Sunday. Inshallah, ibadallah, inna Allah bada bi nafsi thumma thanna bi malaikati qudsi faqala wa lam yazal qaila inna Allah wa malaikatu yusalluna ala nabiyya ayuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ighfir al muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qarib mujib ad du'a. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka أنت الوهاب. ربنا إننا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.